Thank you. It is a privilege to get to be here on this floor, and I get to share my story. You know, in mid-2013, my husband Dan and I went in for our 20-week ultrasound as excited first-time parents. We were not prepared for what we were told. We were told our unborn baby had a 0% chance at survival. There were no kidneys. It was a condition called bilateral renal agenesis, or Potter's syndrome. And as a result, our baby would either miscarry or be born unable to breathe because her lungs wouldn't develop. She would literally suffocate upon arrival if we brought her to term. I, of course, was encouraged from physicians to abort my baby. And while there are many reasons that lead women to make that decision, Dr. Jennifer Gunter, who's a women's health advocate, asserts that, quote, terminations after 24 weeks are for severe fetal anomalies. Now, our baby's diagnosis wasn't just severe. It was without any glimmer of hope. And being told that that wriggling, alive, kicking child in your stomach will certainly die, it doesn't just take the breath out of your lungs. It's like hell screaming in your face. And it leaves fear. Miraculously, our doctors were wrong. We pushed forward with that pregnancy and were successful. We'd seen something happen that had never happened before. My baby developed lungs in utero without kidneys. It was an impossible outcome to the medical world at that time. You know, in good faith, our doctors had given us their honest professional opinions. But guess what? Doctors aren't infallible. Well, we wouldn't have known this if we hadn't tried to overcome this diagnosis. And through divine intervention and some amazing doctors who were willing to chart our new waters, literally, we now get to experience our daughter, Abigail, who's holding the Bible for the swearing in here, standing next to me and Speaker Pelosi. A healthy, happy five-year-old who has, she's a big sister, and she says someday she's going to be the boss of mommy's work. Look out, Speaker Pelosi. So since our story became public, I've talked to moms all over the world who, like me, carry their babies into the second and third trimesters hoping to deliver and then are given devastating diagnoses. But what if the doctor is wrong about their babies too? Abigail was the first to survive her condition, but because of her breakthrough, she's not the only survivor now. Radical legislation in New York and Virginia have recently brought late-term or partial birth abortion into the spotlight. But what if we use this discussion to go on the offensive against the potential disease instead of attacking the pregnancy itself? Some parents have been presented with scary prenatal tests that can produce false alarms. These same earnest, loving, would-be parents have made permanent decisions based on what could be incorrect information. What if the baby won't have that significant health condition or disability after all? Or even if she does, what about the loving families eager to raise a child in anticipation of her living a full and fulfilling life? We got to hear Frank Stevens, an exceptionally joy-filled disability champion with Down syndrome, describe at a congressional hearing how he is, quote, a medical gift to society and that his extra chromosome might lead to the answer for Alzheimer's. Science bears this out. Our society celebrates the term diversity. Shouldn't that mean full diversity, which includes all physical and mental abilities or disabilities, as some call? We step onto very shaky ground and we start deciding who lives or dies based on one's abilities or possibly lack thereof in utero. Because despite our best intentions or the best intentions of the messenger, doctor or otherwise, there is a limit to what science can predict. And that's not naivete speaking. That's coming from a mom of a child who is given a 0% chance of survival based on what was at the time sound science. Excuse me. Now, this kiddo has a full adult life ahead of her. Gosh, and those of us who know her are privileged immeasurably. And you know what? Every single child, regardless of their ability, has that same potential if we'll only give them that chance. I believe that care and understanding and compassion are needed at every stage of a woman's maternal journey. But to me, that means empowering mothers to dwell in the realm of the possible, not the impossible, even if it's never been tried before. With that, I yield back.